We enjoyed a warm and mostly sunny day with moderate to gusty northeasterlies. This is Middle Harbour early to mid-morning before the sea breeze kicked in, looking towards Cremorne, Cameray and Crow's Nest. It reached a top of 31 in Richmond and Penrith today, 28 in Blacktown and Liverpool, 25 the top in Terry Hills and 26 in Gosford and the City. Across New South Wales, we saw scattered storms over the north and southeast with heavy rain and severe storms over the central and southern tablelands. Mudgee picked up 27 millimetres of rain, 19 falling in Orange and 9 millimetres in Dubbo and Coonamble. Top temperatures up to 5 degrees above average with north to northeasterly winds, reaching 21 in Wollongong, 22 in Batemans Bay and Newcastle. Much warmer inland, reaching the 30s right across the far west. Tomorrow, troughs and lows will trigger showers and possibly more severe storms over parts of New South Wales and Queensland. Brisbane heading for a mostly sunny day, 27. A possible storm for Canberra, 23. Cloudy in Melbourne, sunshine for Adelaide and a cloudy 24 for Perth. We're expecting rain around the south and the southwest tomorrow morning, moving into northern New South Wales by the afternoon and evening. Heading for a top of 25 in Wollongong and Bathurst, 27 for Wagga Wagga, Albury, Batemans Bay and Bega, a warmer 29 on the way for Newcastle and Grafton, and there is a strong coastal wind warning from Coffs Harbour all the way down to Batemans Bay. Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow. There is a very high chance of showers moving in during the afternoon and evening with a possible late storm. If that rain arrives, we'll see up to 8 millimetres in the city and 3 to 15 millimetres of rain in our west. Heading for a warm top of 29 degrees in Richmond, Penrith and Blacktown, 28 for Kellyville, Parramatta and Liverpool, 26 for Terry Hills and 27 in Gosford in the city. Let's take a look ahead, and Friday will be fine, 27 degrees. Saturday is looking sunny, warming up to 29, a partly cloudy 30 on Sunday. Then it will be cooler and cloudier on Monday, 24 degrees, with just a possible shower on Tuesday. In our west, late showers and a possible storm on Friday. The weekend is looking mainly fine and very hot, heading for 36 degrees on both days. A cool and cloudy 26 on Monday with some possible light showers on Tuesday and Wednesday, Pete.
Hello again. It was another warm and sunny start to the day, but a cool change moved through shortly after lunchtime, sending the city from 31 to 20 in just 10 minutes. It's fallen even further, currently 17. Tullamarine warmed up to 33 before dropping back to 17. The cool change reached Geelong earlier in the day, so it only had time to reach 23 before the southerly winds moved in. Showers and storms closely followed the cool change, and they've delivered the highest totals to southeastern suburbs, 16 at Pakenham, 15 at Lyndhurst and Officer. Moorabbin's had 8 and the city 9. The severe weather warning no longer covers the Melbourne metro area. It has shifted further east. The storms have recently delivered 24 millimetres in 30 minutes to Jembrook, 44 in an hour to Jeralang in West Gippsland. The storms first sparked up in the east of the state and they've continued throughout the day. And while northern and eastern districts warmed up into the high 20s and low 30s, the change moved into the southwest of the state quite early, so it only reached 19 or 20. The cooler air is behind a low pressure trough, and tomorrow that trough is expected to sit over central parts of Victoria. So with the storm activity to its east, it should be dry for most of Melbourne and also through the west. On Friday, a high over the Tasman will direct northerly winds across Victoria, and with the heat driven down from the interior, daytime temperatures will bounce back. Sydney and Canberra are expected to get showers and storms tomorrow. Just showers for Hobart, a top of 22. Adelaide is forecast to be our warmest southern capital with a top of 29. Victoria can expect another mild night with minimums in double figures. There'll be some patchy fog for inland areas during the morning, but the northwest will enjoy another warm and sunny day, cooler through the southwest and Gippsland, and the showers and storms will be confined to eastern districts, generally 5 to 10 millimetres, but up to 20 at Wodonga. Showers will clear Melbourne tonight, but there's still the risk of thunderstorms in the early morning. Then light showers are expected to pop up in northeastern suburbs in the afternoon. After minimums of 12 and 13 degrees, most suburbs are heading for 22 and 23, 24 at Coldstream, 20 at Rosebud. It'll be a dry day for Geelong, and after a low of 12, it's heading for 22. The city is also expected to reach 22 after a low of 14. Then warming up again on Friday, a top of 31. Then a very warm night, a low of 20, and a top of 25 on Saturday, 18 on Sunday, 19 on Monday under partly cloudy skies, 18 on Tuesday and Wednesday. But first, another warm night, not falling below 14 degrees, and then a cloudy Oaks Day with light winds and a top of 22 degrees.
Yeah, that's right, Andrew. Starting from tomorrow, we should see those maximum temperatures return to average. They will climb over the weekend, and to start the working week, we should see temperatures into the low 30s for the city and our western suburbs. Look, we could do with some more rain, but no rain forecast for the next few days. It is looking dry through into early next week. Nice and clear this evening, still 21 degrees here at Wynnum as we check temperatures now across southeast Queensland. And although it was slightly warmer today, still a little below average. Overnight low of 11 degrees at Kununga of the Gold Coast hinterland, the maximum 29 in Ipswich, Redlands 25, Redcliffe and Brisbane 26, Caboolture 27, Gatton 28 and Toowoomba 24 degrees. With the weather map, showers and storms to fire up across New South Wales, Central Queensland, the Northern Territory, Northern WA and South Oz tomorrow, with some of those severe, while a front approaching the southwest of WA will bring some cooler winds and showers. For the capitals, cloudy and cooler for Perth and Melbourne, sunny and warm in Adelaide, a shower or two in Hobart and Sydney, showers and storms in Canberra and Darwin. Queensland partly cloudy for Cairns and Townsville, sunny in Mackay looking at 28, sunny in high 20s across the Capricornia, Wide Bay and Burnett tomorrow. It'll be hot inland, afternoon showers and storms for Mount Isa, possibly extending down into the central west, and that's where most of the rainfall will be over the next few days. Not in the southeast, where tomorrow it'll be partly cloudy, freshening east-northeasterly winds. Overnight temperatures ranging from 11 degrees inland, 16 bayside. Daytime temperatures mid to high 20s, so getting a little bit warmer. Moreton Bay, east-northeasterlies, 5 to 10 knots, so nice and light at first, increasing 10 to 15 during the day. The seas will be below a metre. Brizzy tomorrow, partly cloudy, light to moderate northeasterlies, a top of 27 degrees. Should be a great day. 7-day outlook, well, even better on Friday, nothing more than partly cloudy and 27. Again for Saturday to start your weekend, sunny Sunday 28. Look at Monday, 30 degrees and Tuesday 29. Ipswich, fine Friday and 29. A little cloud Saturday and 29. Sunny Sunday 32. Monday and Tuesday 33 degrees. The Gold Coast partly cloudy, 26 Friday and Saturday. Mostly sunny Sunday and 27. Monday 29 and Tuesday 28. For the Sunshine Coast, fine Friday and a top of 27. A mostly sunny weekend with 27 each day. Sunny Monday and 29, Tuesday about 28 degrees. Over the next few days, there's a large part of our country that'll get some form of rainfall, just not here in the southeast. But at least we'll get some really nice days, Andrew.
Oh, Brenton, it's just delightful down here by the river this afternoon. We're seeing really nice, calm conditions and, of course, very easy spring-like weather today. Temperature-wise, we actually made it up to around 27 degrees at around just after 5 o'clock this afternoon. Right now, it's dipped back down, though, to the low 20s. Across the suburbs, there was certainly some high cloud around, but because it was only high cloud as opposed to that sort of low lingering cloud, it still felt, you know, quite bright, really. We reached 27 degrees at Mawson Lakes and 28 at Norlunga. There have been a whole lot of thunderstorms across the top of SA today. You wouldn't know it down here where it's so calm in Adelaide, but looking very volatile up through the north and hot too, with temperatures climbing into the 40s through the far north. All much more peaceful through the south, where the most we saw in most places was just a bit of high cloud. It was 23 degrees at Kingscote. On the charts, there are a couple of factors at play. A trough drawing heat in from the north and causing isolated storms, and a high hanging out in the Bight. So some variation in the weather around the country. We've got potential storms firing up in Canberra tomorrow with 23 the top, overcast conditions in Melbourne and potential showers for Hobart. In SA, we will look at temperatures climbing. It's not really that pleasant sort of spring weather anymore up through the north, because we're up into the 40s again through Woomera, Roxby Downs and Cooper Pedy. But Port Lincoln is looking much easier with a clear 24. Renmark is expecting a warm and dry day with 34 degrees, while further south, Mount Gambier is remaining mild for now with a partly cloudy 23. This just to hand now a severe weather alert in the north for severe thunderstorms around Cooper Pedy, which could bring damaging winds for the next several hours. On metro waters tomorrow, we're looking at south to southeasterlies, 10 to 15 knots and seas below a metre. So upgrade the temperatures around Adelaide tomorrow, really starting to feel like summer. We're shifting into the 30s at Golden Grove and Elizabeth, and a warm 29 degrees for Marion. The city is expecting 29 degrees and an overnight low of around 11. But of course, the real kicker is on Friday, where we jump up to the high 30s. So we're talking 37 degrees for the city and even up to 39 degrees through our northern suburbs. It doesn't last long, so if that heat is not your thing, you might enjoy the weekend more, with temperatures dipping back down to 24 and 23 degrees.